Hello, my name is Gregor Cuzak and I will represent Slovenia. I like to say it's the most beautiful country in the world, but everybody's country is the most beautiful country in the world, right? Anyhow, I'm really honored and pleased that I can present to you today on the state of, first of all, the ecosystem that I represent, and then on the state of RRF funding available for Slovenia in the area of health and social care. So, I represent Healthday. It's an ecosystem dedicated to innovation in healthcare. And this is what our ecosystem looks like when we come together. So it's one of the events that we had. I think this is the last event before Corona. And we really like to come together from all the different winds, as they might say. So we started in 2014. Primarily, we started as a digital innovation ecosystem, or even not an ecosystem, just a few conferences. But we evolved, and the evolution led us towards general innovation, even wheelchairs, if you want to innovate there, or some other hardware or services. And now you will see in the conference that we're preparing, we are going towards the huge and very, very interesting field of biotechnology. So our conference on 18th of November is ready to feature some really top-notch, even global, innovators in this regard. Slovenia is a small country, so 1,000 people in this ecosystem is actually a huge number. And we are one of the ECH Alliance ecosystems. My personal role is that I also work for the ECH Alliance, so we definitely use the same methodology, which is talking to everybody, talking to different stakeholder groups, starting with the patients. So just in one slide, what we are based on three pillars. You see there at the bottom. First pillar is company support. Second pillar is we talk to the regulators. We talk to, we're considered as neutral, and they like us to bring together these different aspects. We work a lot with patient organizations. And we are also, you know, partner to the government and to the National Institute of Public Health and other relevant organizations. The last column is about communication, so events, social media, newsletters, and stuff like that. We do a lot of that. So let us go to the RRF. So I would say this is rather a little bit complicated slide, but it shows two main points. The Slovenian RRF funding is somewhere in the middle in terms of Europe. If we compare it to the GDP, we're talking about 1.88 billion, but the number dedicated to health and social care of 420 million is one of the highest in terms of the proportion. So this is just the starting point. Now, just a few of these key elements. So I don't want to bring you the whole picture because it's, you know, publicly available at a few clicks and search via Google. So the key points here are digital transformation in healthcare was given 83 million. So the backstory here is that in December, when the first submission was given, it was just 9 million. So we were really sad when we heard that it was just 9 million. So 83 million, of course, is much better. But still, you know, we are putting very little into informatics. This number of 40 million, approximate number that we put into informatics, deals with even the last laptop that a doctor and a nurse will use in a hospital, and it's really hard to work on that. We should have every year three times the budget just to be average in Europe. And the next item in the RRF is the setting up of the long-term care system. It's 79 million. But here is that we have tried to put this together for the last 20 years, almost 20 years. And it's been almost, you know, like a never-ending story. And the reason why it's a never-ending story is the actual yearly cost is 600 million. So it's a huge tax item or some kind of public funding issue. Can we afford this? Can we not afford this? It's also a political issue. So it's been, you know, just moved around as some hot potato. And this figure, the 79 million, is just really a setup. But it's very good that this is happening. The third one is 110 million going for two new infectious diseases clinics in Ljubljana and Maribor, two of the biggest cities. This is very good that that we have this funding. It's fantastic to see these moves happening. However, we should be more sophisticated. Money should not just go towards bricks and mortar, which is here mostly the case. I think this was influenced by the fact that the RRF came to be in the second wave of Corona. But anyhow, I think it's very good that all of this is happening and that we will be able to move this new energy, new momentum into further development of our ecosystem and better support for the ill and also, of course, for the elderly and other groups in need. And this is it from me. You're welcome to visit, you're welcome to call, you're welcome to write. Thank you very much and enjoy the meeting today.